today with some rap songs by Earl Sweatshirt. Today, I'm gonna have to say dislike it, but before you start, you know, saying, oh, mid opinion, listen to this. This album was so out of left field, like, it was, like, I don't even know how I could have expected it. That's how, like, crazy this was. I completely understand why people say this is a great album stuff. Just first listen, it just honestly wasn't for me. It was just so out there. Like, the beats were crazy. I don't know. But anyway, here's what I added to the playlist. Boom!
Today, I listened to some rap songs by Earl Sweatshirt. Let me tell you what I thought.
I think I am definitely gonna get some people upset with me for this one.
All right, let's just start here. I appreciate the artistry of this project. My understanding is that Earl released this after experiencing a lot of personal trauma, and so a lot of the production was made to sound disjointed and a little bit all over the place to, like, kind of reflect that mental state. The vocal lines were muddied in post-production to show the heaviness he felt due to his depression. I mean, the lyrics on this one are just straight poetry. Like, they're really, really strong. But based on this first listen, this album was a little too disjointed to be digestible. Like, at times, this album was straight up difficult to listen to. Like, it physically felt like an anxiety attack. I see it. I respect it. I appreciate it. I hate it. I've been told this album is a grower, and I trust that. I just don't think that you should have to put in a lot of effort to like an album. What do you think of this album, and what should I listen to next?
You know that song, Jesus Is The One I Have Depression? The Zach Fox and Kenny Beats one? I was fully expecting this album to be just like 25 minutes worth of that. I mean, look at the album art. Some rap songs by Earl Sweatshirt. The instrumentals on this album. Bang on. As in, like, this is perfectly the sort of stuff I like. One of my favourite ones was the track On The Way, featuring Standing On The Corner. This vintage, aged feel mixed with this suave, summery, chill vibe on the guitar. It's got this awesome motion to it. The biggest track here, Riot, reminded me of Goodie Bag by Still Woozy. Sounds oddly similar. Do they sample the same thing? And that's only like a 1 minute song. I actually quite like how short all the tracks are, because it feels like a showcase. Like, it's showcasing all these different vibes, all these different samples, all these different ways of approaching the instrumentals, before then moving on to another thing. Like flicking through images in a photo gallery or something. Like a taster of each thing. Nice.
I'm fine. I'm gonna be okay. I'm gonna be just fine. I'm just gonna be just fine.
Can I paint some rap songs by Earl Sweatshirt in only the length of the album? That's just 24 minutes and 47 seconds. This is day 13 of 50 painting every day until 2023. The time limit made the already blurred and messy cover even more abstracted. But what do you think of that? Are you rocking with the painting, or are you gonna riot? Follow to see what I paint tomorrow.
Earl Sweatshirt, some rap songs. You asked for it, British man. You've heard this album before. You've probably rated it as a 10 out of 10, or you've probably put it on one of your best lists. You don't need me to tell you how to feel about it. Just understand that this is my perspective and my opinion on what I felt about it. In my opinion, this album is not perfect. Despite being surprisingly short, this album took me on a wild journey where new tracks just suddenly appeared out of nowhere, at least sonically. Samples cut suddenly, and Earl Sweatshirt just switched where he rapped in the beat on certain songs, and it was amazing for certain parts. It felt chaotic, and the thing about chaos is it's unstable. This album's style lends itself to many of these tracks, but it takes away from others, I feel, especially in the latter parts of this album. For example, the track Veins felt way too off-kilter for me to enjoy it. That's gotta be the worst one on here for me. This album's unique, it's not perfect, and I think it's good.
Shook a bit. Sookie niggas wasn't shit. Face looking like I stumbled out of pit. $100 chip. I pissed problems out the bottom empty. Mama said she used to see my father in me. Said I was not offended. Press King, Navy Med, Mike on the bench. Living life like a nigga put a price on my head.
Sweatshirt Some Rap Songs is like playing several poorly recorded and severely damaged tape loops while filling every page in your smallest notebook with eloquent self-analyses and abstracted drawings of the Grim Reaper. This is an esoteric yet affecting document of hip-hop's longtime boy prodigy becoming a man. Life is good. Music is better.
A human requested this.
Some rap songs. Why is this an album cover?
Remember when they had my grandmammy on a drip drink? How much of that gin strength could have filled a fish tank? My doggy hip
flushing through the pain. Depression, this is not a phase. Picking out his grave can't help but fill out a place. Try and cast a raise. Death that has the sour taste. Bless my pot, she sent him off and not an hour late. Still is shocking out my heart out somewhere on the range. Out of range.
Double back when you got it made. 30 racks of weed, no fat, yeah. The collar green.
Look, my mood really swinging out perus like a native would do. What I'm thinking I should do for the sake of myself. No games with this cash, go play with yourself. We stay on your ass, your sense of safety melting the flash bang. Don't know what I'ma say, cause I don't label the bags. I stay in them, see you shooting, but your angles is trash. Don't play with us, I revisit the past. Port wine and pages of pads. Mama say don't play with these scabs. It's safe to say I see the reason I'm bleeding out. I need you now. Close lips, make them mouth. Breathe this frown. Two's a team, three a crowd. 12th Street, I kept some lean around. Help me, it's been a minute since I seen a decent count. The wealth be the labor's fruit. The loop hold up the belt. Jesus felt. All praise is due. The juice unobtainable. Like Tang in the booth. Dark face on the news. Clouds gray on the move. On the way like the truth. Yeah.
Your only personality trait is that you like One Direction.
I like 5 Seconds of Summer too, bitch.
Better album than Some Rap Songs by Earl Sweatshirt. Let's see who we get. Tyga, not even on his best day. Let's see who we get next. Hopefully it's someone good. Do they have a better album than Some Rap Songs? I do not know. Blueface, again, no shot. Let's see who I get last. Let's see if we can get Earl some competition. Let's see who we get. Travis Scott, yeah, I'll give it to him. Riot by Earl Sweatshirt is a beautiful, beautiful song and definitely one of his best. But I think one of the most awesome parts is who it samples. In this song, Earl Sweatshirt pays tribute to his late great uncle, Hugh Masekela, by sampling the song of the same name by him.
We built the bridge, we hold the core sender, cease and desist to your deeds, nigga. Please do a board, I could feel when you're forcing it. Still in the board rhythm, or I take the toy.
Thank you.
when they had my grandmammy on a drip drink. How much of that gin straight? Could've filled a fish.
That real music, man. Come back home. Motherfucker, see how real it is.
Think about it. This bitch Dora. And here come y'all in the comments. Berlizzi, you can't call Dora a bitch. That's not right. Man, fuck Dora!
So I listen to some rap songs by Earl Sweatshirt, and I genuinely mean this when I say it. It is the worst album I have ever heard in my life.
Tiptoeing over more than a brick.
Here's my super hot take of the day, and you guys are welcome to argue with me down in the comments. I'll probably make another video explaining why I think this, but my hot take is that Earl Sweatshirt's Some Rap Songs and Kendrick Lamar's To Pimp a Butterfly, they're both 10 out of 10s, but Some Rap Songs is better than To Pimp a Butterfly. That's my hot take of the day. Let me know what you guys think.